This is what we've always wanted. What we've needed. Yeah, so my armies, once this comes off of in the three turns it's gonna take to recruit these guys, should be in a better location or a better position.
Yeah.
Sorry that took so long.
No problem.
If you played fast enough, you could win as the barbarians. Yeah, but the problem with the barbarians is you either had win immediately or lose slowly once they finally got the better units. Like, there was no real option to go strategically late, you know?
Well, I mean, it was also a double clusterfuck, to be honest, because it was like... Because it was kind of like, well, you know, not only are your barbarians at a disadvantage because, fuck you. It was also like, not only are your barbarians at a disadvantage, but the way the game works, if you try and be tactical, then you're going to get fucked because the game, the fights move so fast and, you know, everything like that. And also... Not only that, if you just blob up, the enemy is superior, you're going to die. So it's like, alright, so awesome!
You can't be tactical because the game is too arcadey, and you can't death blob because your blob is too...
So, you know, like, I played a fair amount of, I played a fair amount of Rome 2 Total War. I put some of it up on my YouTube. And you can watch the videos and just see me slowly lose all faith in humanity. You know, I start off and I'm like, oh, I'm really looking forward to this. And like two episodes in, I'm like, okay, this is fine. This is fine. Everything is going to be fine. And then like 10 episodes in, I'm just like, just push the button.
Just auto. Just auto everything.
Just end it all. End me. End me now.
Yeah, I just remember playing those games with the, you know, inheritance, and, like, you get your one good general, and you're, like, you're marching through and getting all these accolades and beating the shit out of people as Romans, because that's what Romans do, and, you know, and then you have your first child, and you're like, this child is useless, why would I ever use him to do anything? And then you die of scurvy at age 43, and your useless child takes over everything, and then you just lose because he's useless.
See, that's what I love about Crusader Kings, is like, if you have a useless child, you can just like put him in jail or assassinate him or, you know, any of these horrible things, and
and you couldn't have, the thing that really bugged me about that game is like, I couldn't just keep having children. I could just keep popping out babies until I got a decent one.
Yeah.
Like, that wasn't an option. And I was personally offended that wasn't an option. Because it seemed every general I had was like, I got an erection once and I've lain with a woman. I will now never lay with a woman again.
Praise me!
Praise me!
I have had the sex.
I have had all sexual relations.
Let's see. Broken Tooth, Black Orcs. You know what? I'm going to give you these guys as well. Use them as a hammer.
Okay.
Does that mean nothing to you?
Well, the hammer versus anvil tactic, I'm assuming, is you want me to smash into somebody. That's generally how the hammer and anvil works.
But... So when I say use them as a hammer, I mean like the
as
anvil.
A blunt instrument.
Yeah. Basically, run them behind, and then my unit is the anvil. You're the hammer. Get me?
Yes. Yeah, which is literally what I just explained.
I mean, like, shut up.
Okay. We'll do that thing you said that nobody's ever thought of before.
No, I'm not saying I fucking invented it, Yujoon. I'm just saying, do the thing, and you were like, oh, what is that like? Is that like the words that you were just saying? I was like, yeah, that is the words I was just saying. And you're
I just
said them. It's like, fuck you, I just said them too.
No, you didn't say, oh yeah, that thing you just said as a validation. What you did, Sheepy, was go, I'm going to ignore what Yujoon just said, even though it was technically correct, and explain it. You mansplained to me.
And
what just happened there. You decided that I didn't actually get it enough, and you had to explain it again.
I mean, not untrue.
Yeah, you let your leader sit to recover a battle. He's a glutton now. Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. Or you're just like, oh, I'm just gonna chill for a little bit on this, and then it's like, oh, yeah, no, don't do that. That means that your entire army is now like entrenched and crap.
Yeah. Or you decide that you want to.
Artillery, please.
You want to give your possibly worthwhile child some battle experience, so you give him the army. You're like, it's okay. My guy will go be a senator or something. And then he's like, ah, yes, he's decided he likes political pursuits, and he's now worthless in battle. Sorry.
Ah, yes, the sweet release of death.
he was poisoned at his first Senate meeting. Sorry. Ow, no, don't, no, stop it. They're firing rocks at me, sheepdog.
I know, there's goblins strapped to the rocks.
It's very unfortunate and uncomfortable.
If you listen carefully, you can hear the goblins screaming as they fly past, strapped to the rocks.
They're still alive, goblins?
Yeah, they're still alive, goblins.
Nice.
Okay. Sorry, just pausing it for a moment, because we need to charge, otherwise we're going to get destroyed by artillery.
Yarp.
Yarp.
By the way, question for Sheepdog. Has Peachy shown you your cameo in his stream today?
Yeah, I saw it. He said I had to be put down.
You had to be, like, a...
It was playing some...
Like a wounded animal?
Yeah, he was playing some Barbie game, and apparently it was, like, dogs and stuff like that. And the dog had fleas. And Peachy's like, oh, I'm gonna have to put Sheepdog down, because the dog was called a Sheepdog.
Well, unfortunate.
I mean, for the dog, yeah, I'm pretty sure, you know, I don't actually have to be put down because I have fleas.
But are you confirming that you have fleas?
Sure.
And you don't need to be put down because of it, or?
Well, I mean, do I need to be put down because I have fleas?
I don't know. I mean, that's not my call to make.
Okay, so yeah, I've done all the things. There we go.
Okay, so we're charging up, yes?
Yeah. Don't you hate it when you tell your entire army to charge and then one group is just like, you know what? Why don't we just walk? It's like...
Yeah, well, I mean, walking's a pretty reasonable assumption to the charge command. Like, oh, yeah, I mean, those guys are running forward. They're gonna die.
Ow, ow. Ow! Stop firing! Stop firing! Luckily, I've got pretty hard. Ow! Ow!
Yeah, I have taken a lot of damage on these great weapons thanks to the artillery.
Yeah. Where's Grimgor? Grimgor!
Grimgor! Grimgor!
Why are the trolls moving so slow? Oh, the trolls aren't charging? Ah, shitties. Shitty shitties.
Shitty titties.
Shitty titties. But then again, Grimgor's having fun. You know, I'm not gonna deny him that.
So, I charged the guys into the cannon.
Ah, sweet. Thank you.
And now I'm gonna do the hammer thing.
Yeah, luckily my orcs are still strong as bulls. So, like, they took a significant amount of damage from the artillery and that, but they get in with, like, you know, half of their unit left, and it's like, oh yeah, we can still rip them apart.
Jesus Christ. I almost feel bad for the little dwarves.
Ah, fuck dwarves.
Go get them, Squig Riders! Ah!
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! You have guns, I have squigs! Squigs!
Squigs! Yeah.
Squig, squig! Squig, squig! Damage sustained! I'm attacked in my flank. No, I'm not. I attacked them. How am I attacked in the flank? Makes no goddamn sense. That's not how science works.
I mean, do you even know science?
I do know science, as a matter of fact. Wavering. Yes, waver.
All night long, all night.
I've got another confession to make. I'm no fool.
Sure. Squigs! Squigs!
Getting
squigs
the best,
anywhere!
The best.
Oh God, best, no!
The best of you.
Fish.
Well,
I was outside the log.
Holy shit! Do you know how much damage Grimgore does to the enemy?
Lots.
He does like 400 lots. HP to this. This is the dwarf legendary lord, and he does 400 HP damage per hit.
Well, I mean, he's dead now. I mean, yeah. He's not a legendary anything. Now he's a dead dude.
Bloody hell.
Bloody hell.
Bloody fucking bollocks, love.
So I watched a show the sure. other day called An Idiot Abroad.
Oh, it's like the most European view of British people ever, and it's legitimately like what Europe thinks of England. The show.
Well, I have to be honest. It's nice to see you guys getting shit on for being uncultured swines for a little bit.
Well, this is the thing, is it's not untrue.
Yeah, and oddly enough, it's like they shit on you for being uncultured, so you shit on us for being uncultured. Who do we get to shit on for being uncultured? Because I don't know where we go. I don't know where the next step in the poll is. Do we get to shit on Russia for being uncultured?
I mean, don't you?
I don't know. I'm kind of stuck at the screen. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm still loading.
Okay. Canada? We cannot shit on Canada. Canada is like... Canada is the cooler younger brother that our parents always wished we were.
It's not. It's so... Canada is a fucking wreck.
Oh, I mean, it certainly is. But it's you know, presenting itself better.
It's got better PR.
It's got better PR. It's not like the little brother is actually better than you. Like, you've got a job, you work hard, you have a house, and your little brother is living at home, but he played really well in that piano recital once, so your parents love him more. That's basically how I view the Canada-US relationship.
I'd say the little brother also maybe, like, drools a bit, and, you know, maybe has
a stay-at-home stoner wasn't enough. He has to also have a drool now.
I mean,
wait,
you know,
this
like...
other Beastmen horde wants a non-aggression pack. No, if I take a non-aggression pack, people get pissy. So counter offer. You give me money. Lots of it. And I will not give you a yes. Oh, they rejected my offer of them giving me lots of money. Sheepdog, I don't understand.
It's crazies. They're crazy.
Crazy?
They're dumb. Who are these guys and why are they attacking me? Aside from the obvious thing of being dwarves.
Yeah, aside from just being giant douchebag dwarfs. Yes, boss.
I've got another confession to make. I'm no fool. Are you giving me the best
of you? I'm not. I mean, if I'm being entirely honest, I'm not.
I'm no fool.
Or a fool.
Can you
God
give
damn
me
it,
the
they
best?
Built loot Brock.
That's fine. It means I have to run less far.
Oh, so you no longer need... Are you not going to just take a boat?
I'll take a boat, motherfucker. No, because I have to run my dude.
Oh, you've got to run your hero and have him perform an action in their territory?
Yep. Zug-zug.
Decisive victory!
I lost 6 people.
66 people.
Whatever.
I mean, similar, but different.
Similar, and yet different.
And yet, not the same at all. So I see that you're taking some land back.
Raising some land. Basically, there are dwarves all over this fucking area, so I'm just gonna raise all the places. Because otherwise what's going to happen is I'm going to take a place, they're going to take it back when I move, and the whole thing's going to just keep going. You know?
Just keep going all over.
Yeah, so new plan is destroy shit and then build it up later after I've killed all the dwarves.
Okay. I mean, you've got a lot of work to do. Those little hammer dwarves seem pretty entrenched.
Every time I go one place, they fucking... Like, another enemy turns up, and they're like, hey, now we're invading you. And it's like, fuck's sake.
I mean, I did offer to come by and, like...
No, it's fine. It's fine. It's just annoying.
I mean, I wanted to be able to help.
Are you giving
did you
best?
Just run away?
Yeah, hell yeah. That was 2 armies.
Oh.
2 full armies of dwarves. And I have no artillery at all at the moment.
Build some artillery.
I mean, I was waiting for my research on Goblin Doom Divers to come in.
Ah.
Also, just for the record, we may have to finish the series early, because I'm getting close to getting Arachnorok Spiders.
I don't know what that is.
You don't know what the Arachnorok... Oh, I did tell you about this, like, at the beginning of the playthrough of the series. Orcs get a giant spider.
Okay.
Like, legitimately massive spider which crawls around and stomps on people.
Okay, that's fine.
Which I imagine for you is the equivalent for me of if there was a giant shark boss.
It's a little terrifying, but I realize that it is just a video game, so...
Well, you say that. Right. You know, like, we can say that, but every time I play Depth, I cry and almost piss myself.
Well, that's because Depth is designed to make the shark scary and in your face, and it's literally attacking you. This is a spider you will be controlling, and it will be our friend. It will be a friendly spider.
No such thing as a friendly spider. Steve
the friendly spider. That's how I'm going to get through this, so we'll be all right.
Okay.
All right.
As long as we're going to be all right.
We're going to be okay. We're gonna get through this.
Big ass spooder.
Steve the friendly spider. I'm going to take one additional turn to recoup some of my losses, and then I'm gonna go attack this town, Myrmidons, before I swing back up to attack Zovrock. So you've got some time.
Okay.
They just rebuilt Matterka.
Metropolis?
Oh no, they haven't rebuilt it yet. I'm assuming they're going to because they have an army there. So you might it might be even better or even quicker for you.
Okay.
How do you shit upside down? I think I fly next wing is correct. Very, very carefully.
Perfect.
And leaning backwards slightly.
Great and powerful war boss.
Big spooders. It's sexy. When do you get that?
Spooder.
Spooder spiders.
I actually.
So when do you get your spooter spider?
About 8 turns.
Nice.
So it's got to be a little bit of time anyway.
Yeah, we're good. Okay, so even if they rebuild them, as long as we raise them, it still counts towards our total.
Okay.
Because we're at 16, and we were at 13, so I don't think it's gone down, especially because they rebuilt two of the ones that I just raised.
Oh, and crap, bullshit, wank, shit, cock!
You forgot to do something, didn't you?
Yeah. Maybe.
Are you going to get punished for it?
No, it's just going to extend the time I need to do things with.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, no, I also have to build the spider place, and I haven't built the spider place yet.
Fair enough. Looks like the dwarves that are fucking with you are at least fucking with the other orcs as well.
Yeah.
And they have reestablished Matterka. Roarg!
What about Canada? Canada sucks!
Throwing that gauntlet.
I mean, like, this is the thing. Love you, Canada. Is if you want to be all like, oh, we're so progressive and blah blah blah. Like, if you're actually progressive, stop being so regressive.
Okay.
This is the thing. Is like, there's being, you know, like, free and you know, like, liberal and all this kind of thing, and then there's being so free and so liberal that you're not allowed to do anything or say anything or even live.
Well, I mean, they're house dogs. Of course, they're terrible at attacking. Yeah, I get what you're saying. I get what you're putting down.
I'm picking up what you're putting down.
I mean, I'm not picking it up because that involves a lot of effort, but I get it. Basically, is what I'm saying here.
By the way, you can destroy Myrmidons if you like.
I figured that because the other places are closer to you. I also have deductive reasoning.
Ah. Okay.
Just very involved fighting.
What about California? Yeah, California's got a problem too.
California's like, yo, man, we're so inclusive, and we just love everyone that we're going to separate from everyone, and just, yeah. It's fun.
Yeah. I really hope you don't have any Canadian viewers. On the YouTube.
Mate,
have you been ragging on Canada for a while now?
No, I just rag on everyone. So when people are like, oh man, Sheepy's such a dick to so-and-so, and then everyone's like, yeah, but he's a dick to everyone else, so who cares?
You're not wrong. You're not wrong. But in fairness, he is an equal dick to everyone.
I mean, you know, that sounds stupid, but that is pretty much what, you know, like, When I criticize or take the piss out of one set of whatever, then it's like, well, he's also said it about literally everyone else, so
you offer fair and balanced dickings.
Yeah.
I mean, hey man, if you want to hate on us, including people, we'll include you too. We include everyone. Floof Knight throwing down.
I mean, do you? Cause like,
welcome back, Lindsay.
Hell yeah. Let's have this fight.
Sabi! Bro, show me some fights. Your wish? My pleasure, I guess? Orc fights!
You shit my hands.
Your will, my hands. My big,
and my throbbing hands. Cock. Yeah, it's the slightly less child friendly version of Lord of the Rings. It's like, you have my bow and my axe and my throbbing cock.
Yeah, well, see, I was combining Spartacus and the Neverending Story.
That sounds like a terrible combination.
I would like to see the Spartacus Neverending Story mix up. And I think that would be very interesting. The Neverending Story. And then the Atreyu gets his head fucking cut off. And the princess is, for some reason, has giant tits. And she's getting boned by the giant rock golem. Who's now a landed, you know, Roman senator. It's like, I could make it happen. You know? Sabi 45, boom! Thank you for your follow and welcome to the Bed of Sloths. Hope you enjoy your stay. What happened while I was gone? Nothing, man. Just we did some things, and then we did some stuff, and then some things and some stuff happened.
I'm talking about sodomy, sodomy,
Bodomingo! Hey, bud, how you doing? And you are married. Yeah, I am married, as a matter of fact.
Let's get sodomy.
Is the castle Yujoon's House of Horrors in your version of Neverending Story? Of course it is, man. If I can get the naming rights, of course.
The Neverending House of Horrors.
The Neverending House of Horrors. The horrors never end, but you sure do. Happily.
Holy fuck me.
Well, I mean...
But like, just my Night Goblin archers got wrecked.
Well, I mean, oh god, jeez. They don't have artillery, they just have better archers than you do. Holy, dude, they have a lot of archers.
Please get far enough. Go on. Go on. Go on. You can make it. I believe in you.
I'm not sure the archer fight is what you want, man.
No, it's not.
The fact that they were willing to engage in the archer fight should tell
you. Well, they attacked
the archer fight.
They attacked, so. So they have to to move forward. Be aggressive. Be aggressive.
Aggressive. Oh, we stopped. I was excited.
Well, I really like that. I really like that film, just purely because Eliza Dushku's in it. And I'm not really a fan of skinny chicks, but she pulls off.
She pulls off being skinny?
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't realize being skinny was a thing you pulled off.
I mean, like, this is the thing, right? Is I'm not being down on skinny people. But they're just not very attractive. Like Angelina Jolie, for example, was way more attractive when she was... she had a bit more skin on her.
Oh, yeah, I agree. Angelina Jolie from...
Gone in 60 Seconds?
Gone in 60 Seconds. Even Angelina Jolie from... what the hell? Tomb Raider.
Yeah, yeah.
Angelina Tomb Raider, hot as shit.
Yeah.
I mean, that was some hot feminine flesh.
And then she went into like.
I'm gonna lose 9,000 pounds and.
Yeah, it's just like, you know, if you wanna.
Charge!
It's like if you wanna be attractive, then maybe don't turn into a like. Who has ever said, you know what, I'd love to have sex with that skeleton?
Well, I think the problem is, like, runway models are all ridiculously razor thin. So people seem to think that that's beauty, right? Like, that's...
Yeah.
Because if that's what runway models are, obviously that is what we view as beautiful. But it's like, no, runway models are that thin because you don't want the model to be drawing cover. Like,
oh no, that's
you want them to be as narrow as possible to draw like the angles of the clothes. Like, you want angular models that don't need to fill anything out so that the clothes shine. But that's not like, I mean, it is, I guess you could say that they are beautiful in terms of the face, but that doesn't make them necessarily sexy.
No. I mean, like, I have my own opinions on this, as you probably can guess.
Lay them down, bud. I mean,
so okay. So look at it this way: is, you know, women are always like, oh, you know what men want? Men want like skinny model type. You know, that's like the standard of beauty that everyone accepts because that's what men want. And I'm like, no, like I know a lot of men, and A, not many men want that. B, the ones who do want that generally tend to be silly dickheads. And C, men do not control the fashion industry.
No.
You know, like, the standards of beauty set forth by the fashion industry is what women respond to. So in actuality, what this whole, like, skinny nation, like, society has, how it came about, is women went, this is what we think is pretty and attractive. So, you know, the standards of beauty being a skinny model is set forth by women, as far as I'm concerned. Not all women,
I think it is both men and women, in the sense that it's a cycle that feeds on itself, right?
Yeah, but I no. What I would say is it was initiated by women, and men kind of, you know, like, joined on that idea.
Well, I would argue that only because men controlled the fashion industry for a very long time. But it wasn't all men. It wasn't like the gender of male said this is attractive. It was like,
no,
the nine dudes that ran the fashion industry said this is attractive.
I mean, like, this is the thing, though, is, you know, you can definitely say that men were in control of the fashion industry. They were, you know, like, setting out what goes out. But at the end of the day, the power lies with the consumer, and the consumer were women always. So, like, yeah, I agree with you that, you know, like, there was a certain dictate from the people making the fashion, from the people engaged in fashion, which at the time were men, but still, the power lies with the consumer in the end. Can you run down those?
What time frame you're thinking about, because if you're talking about, like, Victorian or something, if you're talking about era where women were not in the workplace, they were not the ones earning the money, then the men were the consumers, not the women.
That gets a little bit, like, specific, I'd say, because, you know, like, if the women are the ones buying the clothes, like, in the Victorian era, you know, they weren't having their husbands buy them the clothes. They were deciding what was kind of, there was a little bit of male fashion, I guess, you know, like, what to wear, what not to wear, but, you know, I'd say the majority of the time, the women would be like, This is what's acceptable at a dinner party or whatever, you know, and then people would respond to that.
Okay. Why is Katie? Sorry, Sheep. I'm gonna mute myself for a bit. Okay.
All right. Why did I join into? And hello.
Hello.
Normal random talks. I don't have very popular opinions, by the way, guys. Just FYI. And, you know, like, as I've said a multiple of times, these are like a mix of opinions and theories. You know, I don't treat them as fact, so keep that in mind. What were you talking about? I didn't pay attention. It's fine. Don't worry about it. You have very British opinions? I'd say a little bit, yeah. Maybe. Ah, those sneaky buttholes. Okay. Hopefully those guys will be hired in. Okay, let's just do this.